In this video, I am going to discuss about the Madagascar software, which is used for seismic data analysis, and the environment we will be using the Madagascar using Python language. So a little bit introduction to the Madagascar software. So this Madagascar software is quite popular and which is used the shared environment from the computational data analysis in geophysics. So how you can get the software? So you can get the software from this website, which is ahay.org. So I have already explained all the process, how you can get the Madagascar and how you can install the software in your Linux version. So this video is actually more about the software details. How does it use and why we use this Madagascar software? So the benefit of this Madagascar environment actually consists of the standalone programming for out of the core data analysis. Then we have the standalone programming for geophysical data processing and imaging. So either you want to have the wave modeling or signal processing, data processing from scratch to migrated data, then you can do your modification, you can use your own approximation, or either you can develop your own algorithms on the Madagascar platform. And this software is, or the codes are developed in C, C++, Java, Fortran -77, Fortran 90, Python, MATLAB, and Octet. So these are the developed kit in the Madagascar environment. So there is actually a framework for this reproducible numerical experiment, which is based on SConstruct. So SConstruct is a main file or the environment which we use in Madagascar software. I'm going to into detail. I'm going to show you the detail of this SConstruct, how we have built this SConstruct file. So also a framework for scientists for scientific publication based on SConstruct and LaTeX. So this is software is also a collection of reproducible scientific articles, also use example and the regression tests for this standalone program. So whatever you want to publish, you can generate the code for that and you can publish through the Madagascar website as well. Or you have the published data, then you can bring it here and correlate or merge with the Madagascar environment. And there is a lot of collection of data set which is used as an input to reproducible numerical experiment. So we have some data set from 6B Gulf of Mexico. Then we have salt body deposit. That is, I'm going to show you some of the data set example. So now the important thing is, what is your role to use this Madagascar? So there are three roles which you can be as a user of Madagascar. Or either you can be author of the Madagascar and also the developer of the Madagascar. So let's say if you are a user, so you will learn about the Madagascar, how to use the processing program and build the script. So initially, normally we are the user. Then if you want to become the author, then you will learn how to build the reproducible documents in Madagascar. And as a developer, you will behave like building a new Madagascar program that adds the additional function to the Madagascar. Like I have shown some of the example, so you can add your own program to the Madagascar as a developer. So the most important thing is RSF file, which is regularly sampled format. This is actually the hierarchy of Madagascar, and fundamentally everything built off of the RSF file format. So as you go up to the chain, the complexity level may increase, but the capabilities of the processing package increase as well. So So how does this regularly sampled format files work? So actually we have the combination of LaTeX, which is allows you to make the documentation by combining the other features. Then we have the Python to run our codes. Then we have the SConstruct. SConstruct is the script file which normally we use to write our Python code. Then in SConstruct we have the vplot. So vplot is normally to display our results with the good graphics libraries. And the program is itself is a program to write the codes. So all these combinations actually make your RSF file. So the RSF file format actually contain all of these features. So you have the LaTeX, Python, SCON, vplot and program in together with RSF. So it's a very combination of each and everything. Then you will have the access of all the things which you want to work on. So now looking at the syntax of the Madagascar program, so which is based on SCON. As I mentioned, this SCON is the main source. So the SCON script is also called the SConstruct. So the SConstruct is a simply a text file using Python syntax. So SCON is also a build manager written in 100% Python. So the SConstruct keeps the track of three items for each file built in the scripts. So what are the three main scripts? So in that you have the input file, then you have the name of the output file, and the rules actually Madagascar program with option. So there is a lot of libraries available, so you have to define your input, output and the process which you want to run. And this SConstruct allows us to run the multiple processing command at the same time. So the benefit of this script is you have number of experiment or number of processing together in one file. So that will give you a better understanding. So mainly if we look at the syntax, so its SConstructs are composed of only four commands, which is fetch, flow, plot and the results. So the fetch command normally used to get the data set. If you have data from the internet source, from some library or from some drive. And the flow command is the main command which consists of your input, output and process. Then plot command is the output of this flow. I mean, what flow you have run that will be plotted in this command. And the finally, the result is used to save your flow command. So plot and results sometimes behave as a similar, but obviously the plot will not create a file of RSF or something, it will create the VPL file. So for getting the results in RSF, then you have to run the result. So here is an example of the flow. So in the flow, first we have to give the output file name. Then we have to give the input file, so which is separated by comma. Then we have to give the command. So let's say an example is, so we want to create a file which is spike one, with the input file is spike and the scale which is descale by 4.0. So this is the process, this is your input and this is your output file. So it's quite simple. When you will do the hands-on, you will get better understanding of this syntax. So now we look at the creating SConstruct script. So now you can go into the terminal and you can just open your favorite text editor. So such as you can go for gedit, so vim or emacs, whatever you use. So for my case, I normally use the gedit, so which is still okay for me. So before we can create any flow plot, So there are two things you have to remember. So the first thing is you have to give the first statement, which is from RSF project import. So this first command you must have to give. So this statement actually tells you to SConstruct file where you find the flow plot and results statement. So in between, when you will write some statements, so it will take from the RSF project. If you don't define, then obviously you will not have the access of flow plot results or whatever commands you are using. And the another important thing is the end command, which is the last you have to put with end with the parentheses. So here is one of the example. So this is taken from Madagascar website. So from rsf.project, which is the first command, remember this statement comes first always. Then you have the all process. I'm not going into detail the process. Then in lastly, you will go for the end command. So this is the end command in the end of your script. So once you have done this one, then you can run your script on it. So now moving to our geophysical understanding, how you can read and write your SegWire file or Seismic Unix file. So the SegWire format is actually based on the proposal of the Barry et al. 1975, and it was revised in 2002, as we know. So the SU is a modification of SegWire used in Seismic Unix, which is from the Software 1997. So now what we can do using Madagascar, so we can convert our SegWire and Seismic Unix file to RSF file. So we use the SF SegWire read program, so which is this one, SegWire read. So let's first manufacture an example of file using the SU utility from the structure. So now let's say if you have the SU plane file, so which is actually in Seismic Unix file. So now you can convert your file from RSF or use the these are actually two commands which you can use. So over here, the first statement or the command, you can use the SF SU read. So now you have the SU read. So the plan.su, this is either you want to convert your Seismic Unix file. So in this, you have to give the T file, which is TRSF, and Indian, you can define either it's 0 or 1. Then greater than plan.rsf. So now it will convert from your input, which is the SU file, to RSF files. If you have the SegWire file, then you have to use SF SegWire read. Then you give the input. Sorry, this is your output, and this is your process, and this is your output file. This is your input, then this is your output file, plain.rsf. So after running this command, you can convert your data from size SegWire or either Seismic Unix to RSF file. So I think that's all for this lecture. Then I hope you can follow the other videos, which has some hands-on together with the installation process of the Madagascar. Thank you so much and have a good day.